Paul the Apostle was on his way to Jerusalem, and he decided to stop at the church of Ephesus. Now, this was not a large church, a small body of believers. He said, but I'm here to bring you a message. It's a message that I brought to you, and I'm going to give you one last warning. He said, for 3 years, I preached in your church with tears. For 3 years, I went house to house warning you what's coming to your church. He's not talking about church growth. He's not talking about anything. He's talking about something he sees coming inside the body, inside the walls of the church. The Holy Ghost has made you overseers to feed the church of God, which he's purchased with his own blood. He's saying, pastors, elders, feed the flock. Get your people well fed. Because the enemy that's coming is going to go after the weak sheep. He said, feed the flock. God's made you overseers. Now you feed the flock because something is coming to deceive and try to scatter this flock. For I know this, that after my departure, shall grievous wolves enter in among you, not sparing the flock. Also of your own selves shall men arise, speaking perverse things, to draw away disciples after themselves. Therefore, watch. I tell you folks that not even this church can be spared. Not a church on the face of the earth can be spared of what Paul saw coming in his day and even to the last day. And it's what has already come to the Church of Jesus Christ here in America and around the world. Revelation 2, Jesus said of the Ephesian church, this is years later, he said, you've left your first love. Why did they leave their first love? I believe they left their first love, and the Lord said, you better repent, lest I take away your lampstand, lest you no longer be a witness to the world. And I believe what happened is the very thing that Paul warned about. They were not careful. He said, there's going to be wolves come. There's going to be perverse people rise up in your midst. And they're going to start teaching error. They're going to teach things that are perverse. Perversity here in the original Greek means tenacious promotion of error. But he said there are wolves that are coming. And they're not going to spare the flock. They're going to be self-seeking. They're going to make merchandise out of you. Beloved, Paul the Apostle is gone. He's not here. But the wolves and the perverse teachers have come. These wolves have invaded the house of God. I see these wolves all over the world. I see these teachers of perversity, of error in the Church of Jesus Christ of God. It's splitting churches. It's scattering sheep everywhere. These are money-mad preachers on television, money-mad preachers saying that God's desire for you is that you have the best car, you have the best house, you have the best of everything. And there's not one word of sin, there's not one of repentance, not one word of the cross. It's all money, money, money. How blind so many Christians, how blind so many pastors being led into the prosperity gospel. And at the end of it, they were singing a song, run for the money. Saints, wake up! Their houses are full of deceit. They've become great and they've become rich. They're fat and sleek, but they don't plead the cause of the orphans that they may prosper. They do not defend the rights of the poor, so I not punish them. An appalling and horrible thing has happened in the land. They're prophesying falsely, and my people love to have it so. But what will you do at the end of it all? What would you do when the hard times come? Pastors, leaders, Paul says, guard yourself first of all, and all the flock that you oversee, feed them. My work and the work of every pastor, our greatest concern is to make sure no wolves get into this congregation, that you never become prey to a perverse gospel. I know how I pray, God, never. And as long as the pastors that you have now are in this pulpit, There will never come, God helping us, there will never come a wolf into this pulpit. There will never come a perverse gospel into this pulpit. You better check it out. You better check it out before you get the virus that can poison you and destroy you. God warned Amos that Israel is going to face a famine. Not a famine of food, but a famine of the Word of God. And folks, this is the great concern of our Heavenly Father, that that kind of gospel that takes you away from cross, takes you away from self-sacrifice, takes you away from the prayer closet, takes you away from repentance and brokenness before God. Anything that takes you away from that is going to cause you to end up in a famine. That, he said, I told you to seek first the kingdom of God and His righteousness. I'll take care of all these other things. You seek me first. You go after holiness and righteousness. I'll take care of you. Even in hard times, unemployment, I'll take care of you. If when he seeth, this is the watchman, if when he sees the sword come upon the land, he blows the trumpet and warns the people, then whosoever hears the sound of the trumpet and takes not warning, if the sword come and take away, his blood shall be upon his own head. He heard the sound of the trumpet and took not warning, his blood shall be upon him. But he that taketh warning shall deliver his soul. But if the watchman see the sword come and blow not the trumpet, and the people be not warned, the sword come and take any person from among them, he's taken away in his iniquity, but his blood will I require at the watchman's hand. So now, O Son of Man, I've set thee as a watchman to the house of Israel. Therefore thou shalt hear the word at my mouth and warn them from me. When I say to the wicked, O wicked man, thou shalt surely die. If you do not speak to warn the wicked from his way, that wicked man shall die in his iniquity, but his blood will I require at thy hands. Nevertheless, if thou warn the wicked of his way to turn from it, if he do not turn from his way, he shall die in his iniquity, for thou hast delivered thy soul.